Hi everyone, I'm Krista Seiden, Analytics Advocate at Google, and today I'm joined by Scott Herman, who is a Product Manager on Google Tag Manager. If you've ever had to update a setting across many of your tags in Google Tag Manager, or if something changes and you have to go in and check everyone, you may have run into the headache of there just being so many tags in your account to update, or one maybe slipping through and not getting that update, and then you're not in a very good place when it comes to your settings, right? So in this quick tip video, Scott is going to walk us through the new centralized Google Analytics settings variable in Google Tag Manager. And this is something I know I'm super excited about, and I think you guys will also be. So with that, I'm going to hand it over to Scott.
Great. Thank you, Krista. So as Krista says, we know that there have been a lot of headaches over the years when it comes to setting up multiple tags that have to work together. And I think the best example of this, or maybe worst example of this, is the Google Analytics tags, which, you know, your tagging on these tags really does need to be consistent. Things like fields to set, custom dimensions, tracking IDs need to be controlled consistently across multiple tags that work together, across the page view tag, across an event tag, and so on. So let's take a look at how this is handled in the old version of this tag, and then we'll show a bit of how it's changing as of May 2017. So we'll take a look at the Google Tag Manager interface, and you'll see here I have a bunch of tags set up already, a bunch of GA tags set up for events, and a standard page view tag, and we'll ignore this last one until I get to that. So if you were going and entering a new Google Analytics tag, I would go and I would click New Tag. My tag configuration here, I'll select Universal Analytics. Now, the standard way to do this, of course, is to enter in a tracking ID. So I will do that here. You know, UA-12345-1, just a sample tracking ID for my Google Analytics property. And I'll note that it's a track type of page view. There's a lot of different track types here, of course. And anything else that I want to set for this tag, such as fields to set, like a cookie domain, I might type in as auto. And custom dimensions, I could add a custom dimension here, index one, and I don't know, let's say maybe page host name, if I have that set up here, here it is. So this will capture that page host name in the index one of my Google Analytics custom dimensions. And I could add a lot of more settings here, but I won't bother with that at the moment. Now, if I were to save this tag, I can do that. GA test tag just for fun. It's fine without a trigger because I'm not actually going to launch this tag. And if I were to do that maybe 10 times, maybe 50 times or 100 times, depending on how many tags I have, if I then needed to go in and change my tracking ID or add a new custom dimension, as Krista was describing, that could be a nightmare, right? You'd have to do that in a lot of different places and make sure that it's done consistently. People have used our API for this in the past, which is a great use of our API. And there are some other workarounds. So if we look at some of the tags that I've already set up in here, you'll note that here I'm using a variable for my tracking ID. I'm using a variable for my cookie domain value. And if I were to click into this and take a look at, you know, let's look at the GA property variable here, you'll see it's just a constant string, and I have a fake UA ID here just for the purpose of this demo. But this is a way that if I wanted to, I could change this value here, and it would change it across all the tags that are using this variable. But of course, this is still not great because it's hard to use. You need to know to do this. You need to set it up that way in the first place. So what we're releasing as of May 2017 is a new variable type called Google Analytics Settings Variables. And I'm going to switch to a new tag type here called the Universal Analytics Beta Tag. Now, as of our public launch, you won't see this as a beta tag. This will just be the new norm within your Universal Analytics tags. But to show you the difference between our previous functionality and this new functionality, I'm in a different environment here with our beta tag. So we'll create a beta tag. The first thing it's going to ask me is the track type instead of my tracking ID like it had done previously. And I think that this is more in line with the way that people tend to think about how they're doing tagging. You know, you might say, I want to launch a new Google Analytics page view tag or event tag. oftentimes when you're adding tagging, you're not immediately thinking of the tracking ID that you want to use. So here I could select an event, I could select the page view. We'll leave it as page view. And what you'll see here is somewhat new. If you're coming into this for the first time after this Google Analytics settings variable release. I do encourage if you're not sure of any of these features, we have these info tips here where you can learn more and click out to our Help Center. But basically, it's asking me to select the settings variable. And you'll notice that there's nothing in here except a prompt to create a new variable. Now, if I had already created a Google Analytics settings variable, that would show up here, right? But it's going to be limited to only those variables that make sense. You're not going to be able to choose some custom JavaScript variable here where it wouldn't actually work. So I'll create a new variable, and this will load a new slider for me. Now here I can enter in my tracking ID. And I can enter in my cookie domain, and you'll notice that we've actually raised the cookie domain field up to the highest level. This is because previously, Google Tag Manager, the Google Analytics tags within it, did not have this cookie domain set to auto by default, but all of the tracking code that you would get out of Google Analytics, out of the public documentation, did include that cookie domain as auto by default. So we are now making that change. There is, again, a nice info tip here which explains that change and why what you might need to think about related to that change. So I do encourage you to take a look at that and make sure that this setting works for your organization. And any of the other settings here, like custom dimensions, same thing holds here. We would do the same thing that we did before and choose maybe the page host name, just as an example. There's no triggering here, right? There's no tag firing priority or anything because this is a variable. And I will name this variable standard GA settings. You can name it whatever you want. I encourage you to name it something that will make sense to any of the other users who are doing Google Analytics tagging in the container. And I will save this. And now you'll notice it's selected here for me. And the next person who comes in, or if I go to create a new tag, this will show up in this dropdown, so I don't need to create a new one every time. If you want to see what's in it, you can click this little info button, and this will bring me back into that summary of that tag. And of course, a question might be, first of all, well, what if I have a settings variable for 100 different tags, and I want to change a custom dimension or change the tracking ID on only one of those, right? Well, no problem at all. You can click this Enable Overriding Settings in this tag checkbox. And now you'll see my tracking ID is available down here, as well as all the other settings. And you can see it says it's inherited from the settings variable. So all of the settings are still being pulled from that settings variable, but you can override them one by one if you'd like to. So in this case, maybe I'll say, well, actually, let's send the data to 12345-2. Right? Now, all the other settings, like the custom dimension, the field to set, the cookie domain, are still going to apply here. Right? So that's generally the gist of this feature. What I would say as well is that you can create as many of these settings variables as you'd like. So if you have a container that spans multiple websites, or you have multiple Google Analytics properties that you're working with, you could set up more of these settings variables. And ultimately, they should help you manage things across lots of containers, add additional custom dimensions without all of this hassle and all these workarounds that we've talked about. So we're really excited to be releasing this feature.
Great. Thanks, Scott. I'm super excited for this because I know I've personally felt the pain of having to update many tags, as I'm sure many of you have as well. So hopefully you guys will try out the new settings variable when it comes out, and hopefully it makes your lives that much better. Thank you.